actually broke the line. Hey folks, I'm Peter Melhorn. In this video, we're going to check out just how much drag is on some of the reels that I use. Well folks, if you've been tuned into my channel for any length of time, you'll know that I use several different fishing reels in my catfishing videos. I use Abu Garcia, I've used Lose Reels, I've used these new ones from Slimecat, and I've also used some from Ancient Mariner. So what I'm going to do is, we've got a scale set up here, and we're going to check out and see just how much drag some of these reels have on them. Some of the findings may surprise you. Unlike when you check the drag on a rod or reel combo that you're fishing with, which you should check it using the rod, running the line out of the rod, loading it up with the rod, because the rod will play a part in how much drag you actually are putting on the reel. We are doing it straight off the reel. We are checking what the drag is at maximum drag straight off of the reel. All right, this is the Lose reel. You've seen me use a bunch. This is the Laser XL. I believe it's a XL60. It's kind of in between a 6500 and a 7000 as far as size goes. But we're gonna put it on here. I'm gonna make sure the drag is cinched down really tight. A couple clicks out of it. Let's see where she lives at. Again, get a good reading on. Make sure the drag is tight, it's not slipping any. Looks like right around 14. Yeah. 13 pounds. I'm gonna go with 13 on that one to make sure it's as tight as it'll go. Right around 13. Not as smooth a drag. It's kind of herky jerky there. We're gonna call this one 13. And I think that's a good fair number for it. Now, the next one is the Abu Garcia 6500 C3. Tight. Never had a drag this tight on one of my reels. Guys here, and that. Wow, guys, I am seeing sixteen pounds. I've had this reel since it was brand new. It's at least 10 years old. It's never had any drag washers put in it. So just a little point of reference there. All of these reels are used. Some of them are newer than others, but at 16 pounds to be as old as this is, it's pretty impressive. Again, this is an Abu Garcia. This is one that is made in Sweden. 6500 C3, great reel. This is one of the Ancient Mariner reels. I've got a couple of these that I've used. And we're going to tighten that drag down on it. Make sure it is as tight as we can get it. Let's put it on here and see where she starts to slip. Nice smooth drag, looks like about 10 and a half pounds. It actually registered a weight right there at 10.13. Okay. We'll call it 10.6. Out of the ones, all the ones up here, this is definitely the smoothest, very smooth drag. That line comes off very smooth. All right, the next one is a reel you see me do some videos on here this year. It's the Salix X from Piscifun. This thing supposedly has 25 pounds of drag on it, according to the literature that came with it. So I am cranking this puppy down as tight as it'll go. And we're going to find out just what the truth is. Looking like about 17. $16.12 is what I'm seeing consistently there. Make sure that sucker's good and tight. Let's see how much we can get. Nope, there we go, there we go, there we go. There's 20. I'm gonna double up the knot on this thing just because this is a lot of drag. I got that sucker a little bit tighter then. There we go, let's see now. Get that. Lined up. Actually broke the line on it that time. That knot actually gave way. That's a lot of drag, guys. That's a lot of drag. I'm gonna put a bimini twist into this thing just to see if that will help. Bam, I got me a bimini twist in that thing now. Hopefully that will hold. Here. All right, let's see what we got, guys. $23. I actually believe it now. That's a lot of drag. They're not lying. I'm gonna call it 23.12. That's a lot of drag. It's a lot of drag on that reel. That's more drag than you're probably ever gonna use. The last one's a brand new one. It's a Slimecat reel. Make sure it is pulled all the way down. Definitely not the best thing in the world to be cranking these things down as tight as I'm doing them. But we're going to do it because we love you. Smooth as butter. It looks like around 14 pounds. I call it 14.5. Oh man, I got a little more out of the drag. I did get a little bit more. It's right around 15 pounds. I'm gonna call that 16. It's tweetering right around there. There you go, guys. That one's got a lot of drag on it. That's pretty dang good. Out of all these reels, that one's right up there with the Abu. They're right there in the same category, same class. So hopefully that gives you some good feedback and some good information on just how much drag is actually on these reels. I'm gonna do this with some more stuff. I've got some 7,000 Abu series reels, some bigger stuff over there that I'm gonna try. I've also got some spinning reels that supposedly have a lot of drag on them. So some saltwater stuff. So it'll be fun to mess around with this just to see where they stand. And I may actually reach out to the guys at Pipeline Tackle down in Alabama, and they put custom drag washers into these reels for you. So if you're looking at upgrading your drag washers, check them out, Pipeline Tackle. I'll put you a link down below. And might send them a reel just to see how much drag they can put on one of these things. Well, folks, if you made it this far, thank you for watching. Here are a couple more videos that I think you're gonna like. I'd watch that one and then that one.
No. No, do that one first and then that one. I don't know. Just watch them both. They're both good.